I never would have guessed you're autistic.
What do you mean?
Well, you make eye contact, you drive, you're very articulate, you don't rock back and forth, you don't act like a child, and you're not a chatterbox.
Well, that's because I'm masking.
You're masking?
Yes, I'm masking my autistic traits.
What do you mean by masking?
Glad you asked. I mask my autism to help fit into your social standards. I'm basically impersonating a version of myself that's not autistic. I'm pretending to be something I'm not to make you comfortable. Because God forbid everybody else can make me, the autistic person, comfortable and give me accommodations. In a world that's very difficult for me to be in. I'm basically acting like a robot for your comfort. I'm trying not to have an autistic meltdown, but you know what? It is so hard because I'm trying to hold it in all the time. Also, you don't judge me. Because guess what? You're judgmental. And God forbid I talk about the one thing that interests me. Nobody pays attention.
Here are five ways I deal with the sink with my sensory issues. Number one is these long gloves I have to wash the dishes. I hate, hate, hate the feeling of water dripping up or down my forearms. They're super sensitive and it can send me into sensory overload. Number two is earplugs or headphones I wear and put a shower cap over them so they don't get wet. Be careful with that. Easy makeup remover, you just rub it off. Great toner to clean my face when I don't have the energy. And these are some wrist puffs. They're made for spas, but they stop the water from dripping up or down my forearms again. Great help.
Hey there. Is there a project you're working on?
I know more than you.
All right.
There are five things you should never say to an autistic person. Number one, you don't look autistic.
How is autism supposed to look?
Number two, oh, so you were vaccinated as a kid? Vaccines don't automatically equal autism. Number three, so you must be really good at math and science. Dude, I'm not Rain Man. Number four, oh, you're autistic? So is my nephew's stepbrother's cousin. Okay. So number five is actually a heads up to you guys, for anybody universally, don't ever, ever, ever use the R word.
This is a reenactment of an actual, real conversation that I had the other day. And just so you know, this person I was talking to does know that I'm autistic. Explain a little something like this. Yeah, I get your point, but if we're talking about ending, you know, mass consumerism, which completely fair we totally need to do, we need to keep in mind how that's going to negatively impact disabled people. Don't say disabled. Why? Well, I don't know, but my mom has actually worked with people with autism for 25 years, and she says you're not supposed to use disabled. Oh, no, people with autism don't like it when you use the word disabled? Yeah, no, she says that we should use differently abled. Well, of course I'm differently abled, but I'm also disabled. Calling someone disabled makes them feel less than, just because they can't do what everyone else can, when actually they can do it. No, so that's actually what disabled means, is that you can't do some of the things that everyone else can. And if your mom thinks that being disabled makes you less than, that's her problem. I don't know, dude, my mom's been doing this for 25 years. I think she knows what she's talking about. So me, as a real life autistic person right in front of you, saying the word disabled, showing you why I would like to be called disabled, is wrong, because your mom, who works with people with autism like me, said that people with autism don't like it. And you also know that I have huge platforms that primarily talk about ableism, so I may talk to more disabled people than your mom does, and I may have more firsthand experience with this than your mom does, and that maybe you should listen to me and other disabled people when we tell you what we want. I'm just saying, if you're gonna call people disabled, like, that's gonna make them feel less than, and that's not okay. People are not defined by the activities that they can participate in. No one is any less of a person because they can't or don't do certain things. Those things that we can't do don't define our worth, they don't define how much respect we deserve, and they do not define our personhood. And so just because someone cannot do things, or they are unable to, they are disabled to even to do those things, does not mean that they are any less than. And if you think that, or if your mom thinks that, that's your ableist mindset telling you that being disabled is bad. Clearly, we're not going to get on the same page, so maybe we should just stop talking about it. Clearly, if you cared, you would listen to disabled people telling you that what you're doing is ableist, but it's whatever, fine.
What's your name? Who's your daddy?
Good girl in a straw hat with her arms out in a cornfield. That is a scarecrow.
I like routine due to my autism, so my fiance drives me to Starbucks every day to get the exact same drink. She's so kind and understanding.
I want waffle fries.
Alright, so it looks like you've got ADHD, OCD, sensory processing disorder, misophonia, and attachment disorder, anxiety, and depression. That's a lot of labels. Well, I mean, it's a classic case of autism, especially based off of your childhood experiences, but you're an adult and you're making eye contact, so no, it couldn't be autism. So, autism? But there's the eye contact, so...
up the rice in the church where the wedding has been.
Mm-hmm.